Hello, my name's Rebecca.
And I'm Steve.
And this is an out-of-character episode.
It is indeed. this week's episode was not where we wanted it to be, so we decided we were going to do this instead. It was very last minute.
Because we're the worst.
I don't think that's the case. No. I think sometimes when you start with an idea for an episode, sometimes you end up not being where you want it to be. We have an idea that's really good, but it works better with a third person. And I think that we just need to retry it with that third person and see. Because sometimes Alufi and Silas explaining things in Eberron is good, but other times it feels out of place.
It feels nice to have specialists on the show. There's a lot of things that Alufi and Silas can talk about just between the two of them. And it'd be good. But there's a lot of things that they can't.
That level of ignorance between both of them means that you get a lot more fun interactions.
Yeah.
Whereas if one of them always knows everything, it kind of makes it a little less fun.
I need to get a little bit of water because my voice sounds so scratchy. So.
Oh, let's start with the thing that we normally do at the end of shows. Let's go ahead and get that shill out of the way initially.
Hashtag call to action. We might ask a handful of questions. That's what they're called, Steve. They're called call to action.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't know.
Yeah, like every time that we're like, hey, comment. So if we ask any questions or just tell us your opinions on any of the things we're going to talk about, use those comment boxes or send us an email, which is housecivisequestation@gmail.com.
We do it every week. How do you not know?
Because I'm really tired. And then, of course, there's our website, which is poorly managed. We're trying to fix it. We're
getting there, guys. We're not getting there. We're pretending.
I wanted to have like a lot more on the website than we do. But it has proven to be just an extra step of things that I don't have time for.
I think when it comes to like the editing, and there are a lot of things that we are enjoying with the podcast, and I just can't figure out how to enjoy editing the website. I don't have any fun when I'm doing it.
My issue is finding things to put onto the website and then taking the time to write those things.
Because sometimes, yeah, like you're like, what's the legality of what we're doing? Like, can we put this picture up? Is that all right? And then that becomes a problem too. Yeah. I think that a lot of times,
as long as you put like,
I think that is part of it as well.
Citations are important. Otherwise, why can Wikipedia pages do it?
That's fair. I don't know. That's an interesting question.
Let's see here. Our website. Check us out on social media. We're on Twitter. We've got a super underused Facebook. We've got an Instagram now that I never look at.
We're going to pretend we have TikToks too, guys.
We don't.
We don't have TikToks.
We've also been talking about getting Alufi and OnlyFans.
Kevin and OnlyFans as well.
Kevin and OnlyFans.
Because as soon as Alufi has something, Kevin has to have it as well.
Yeah.
He's the worst.
I'm trying to get better at social media. I've gotten better with Twitter.
You have. You definitely have. Like, normally it was me running. You've stepped up your Twitter game and it's nice.
Now I have to just step up Instagram and Facebook too.
I was really good at like a lot of the Facebook groups for a while there, but I fell out and I got to get back into just remembering to do that. But you guys are great. I want you to know that.
Because
like after the last episode, we had that small comment about if you appreciate someone, tell them. And then we got so many responses.
So many people were like, I appreciate you, Luffy. And it made my heart really warm.
Yeah, it did. Silas cried for several days. Don't worry, we'll touch on it. We had touched on it. We're going to have to touch on it again and then when we redo the episode.
Yeah.
Because you guys, man, you guys are the absolute best.
So let's move on to the next point we have on this little piece of paper.
We organized a piece of paper here, guys.
We did. What is on deck? So we don't own a boat.
Fuck. You know what? I quit. That's the last pun. I'm done.
So what's on deck?
What's on deck? Well, we have a special materials episode that I was really excited about that we're going to have to work on a little bit.
Yes, that was what was supposed to come out today, or this this week. That is what this episode was supposed to be.
So we wanted to talk about all the different woods of Corvair. Eberron entirely.
I had this stupid idea while I was driving, and I was like, what if we did a thing on Sorwood? Because a lot of people in the Discord were talking about Sorwood, and if it could grow outside of an Eirian manifest zone, and all of these things. And I was like, it'd be cool just to do specifically Sorwood. 20 minutes of Silas and Aluvi talking about Sorwood.
Absolutely not. I'm already bored with that idea. So we talked about doing more than that. We talked about doing different types of woods and bringing in an expert to sit down with us. And initially we were like, an expert idea is a good idea, but we don't have anyone right now. Let's just go with what we've got. And so we're going to do that again. I think that's just the best call. But we're touching on all the different types of wood that are made in the different planes, a lot of different materials from different books. We even have a couple of things that are technically not wood, but are thrown in there just because they can be treated as wood, specifically from the books, some of the earlier stuff. It's all really exciting. I think it's a fun episode. We just have to fine tune it.
Talking about us not having a specialist and needing one. That is an issue I think we found that is coming up pretty frequently, is that we are often like, man, we could use a third voice, but we don't always have a third voice to use.
Yeah, I think that initially when we started this, we were like, oh, we'll do the two, and then we'll do interviews, and it'll be fine, and I've got a lot of different voices that I can do, but then it seems ridiculous talking to myself for the whole episode, going back and forth, or
because when you're editing it, you can tell that it's just you.
Yeah.
And
if I can tell that it's just me, or you can tell that it's just you, everyone else can. So we did the last episode, and we did where we were not all in the booth at the same time. That was the first time we did that.
Yes.
And I don't know if people can tell it. Like, I can tell that we were not all in the booth at the same time. I can tell where the divide is because I was there. So I'm wondering if people can tell that all three of us weren't in the booth. It was weird. It was real weird.
Go back and listen to the last episode.
We're not going to say who was in the booth when, but
somebody was not in the booth, and I would like to know if you guys can tell who had to record their lines later.
Because if it's noticeable, then I think that we might know it, but if no one notices,
another tool in our toolbox.
Yeah, because I didn't think it would work the way that it did, but it really did. It came out pretty nice.
We were also wanting to talk about the different classes in D&D.
We have decided that one of the things that we want to do is for people who we bring on that aren't specifically related to Eberron, we want to give them something that they can talk about that they're passionate about, like the different classes and subclasses in D&D, and discussing what it is to be a fighter in a fantasy setting, or what it is to be a wizard in a fantasy setting, and then making that fit into the theme of the show. And I think that's going to be a lot of fun episodes, so we have those outliers. And then, of course, we also have an upcoming episode on fashion. That'll be a great time as well.
If anybody knows me, and they have seen me on the Eberron Discord, they will know that I am a huge history fashion nerd. Just a big old nerd. And one of my favorite things is talking about like fashion in Eberron, because all of the art is so everywhere. Like, in the 3.5 Dragonmarked book, you've got a lady who's Dragonmarked who's in this, like, slinky little black dress with half of her back showing. But then in Five Nations, you've got, like, women in bustles next to women in togas, and it's just really fun and funny to try and pin down, like, actual elements of fashion within Eberron.
During that, we're also going to talk about different clothing materials, because we thought in the fashion episode, we might as well talk about different makes and
shift weave and glamour weave.
Maybe a couple extra ones that we found in other places as well. It's going to be exciting. I'm really excited to see how all of that comes together. And, of course, we also have the specific houses coming up. We're going to add more of those. We're bringing on different members of those houses. And I think that should be a fun time. And then, of course, Race of the Eight Winds. I think that one is the one that we're most excited about because we are trying to line up 8 different people to come on as the different jockeys. And we've got ideas planned for different bars and different interviews.
We've got ideas for, like, okay, we're going to interview all of the jockeys, you know, in the few weeks going leading up to the race. We had, like, a Luffy being, like, quote-unquote, down on the field interviewing people. We've got ideas for, like, different sports chants for the different teams.
Yeah, I was going to say the different jockeys, the support, the fans supporting them. And then we're going to do, I think, a live, maybe? Maybe live? Just, like, old-style horse race thing, and they're off. And, you know, following the motions and all of that. But I think we have to figure out exactly how long the race typically lasts. There's a lot of mechanics that we have to get together before we can do that. Oh, man, I'm so excited.
If we do that, I want to, like, if we do it live, I'd want to videotape it as well.
Oh, absolutely.
I want to make, like, I don't think that I could do a full Luffy cosplay, but I'd want to make, like, an owl hat and, like, little, like, foam fingers that say, like, the owl and, like, stupid stuff like that.
That would be really fun. And then all I'd have to do is just obscure myself with a bottle of scotch. And then I think I've completed my Silas.
Your Silas cosplay?
That's all it is.
We'll paint a little bit around your face for your mark.
Can we just paint a dragon mark on a bottle of scotch? I think that sums him up significantly right there. If you just have the whole thing done.
Just tape a Sybaris mark to a bottle of scotch.
Right on the label. Oh my god, yeah. I think this is, that's it. I'm done.
I love it.
So, speaking of the Race of the Eight Winds, we do have a couple other experimental episodes that we've been talking about or working on. One coming out next week, which is exciting, which is our...
Oh yeah, the Silas dating episode.
Yes,
the
Silas dating episode.
So, over the next week or so, you will see us releasing flyers and whatnot to our social media, calling for participants for the Silas dating show, that you could be chosen to get on a dating show to take Silas out on a dinner date.
I think that that's a smart move. We've got... poor Silas. Poor Silas. This guy just tries so hard to be happy in his life, and everyone makes him miserable.
Now, if people respond to the flyer, should we choose somebody?
I mean, I'd be delighted to have one of the spots open for another person. That'd be absolutely fine. We could talk to 2 of our guests and see if we can move them to a separate episode instead. Because, I mean, they were coming on to do that as a favor for us.
One of our guests would be perfect for the wood episode.
I don't disagree. Yeah. In fact, I reached out to that person last night and went over a whole bunch of stuff with them.
Anyway.
Because anything related to plants, I'm like, all right, I got to message them.
I don't know why we're being secretive. She's one of the players in our...
Hi, everyone. Tessa. Oh, my goodness. I love you so much.
Hi, Tessa. I love you. what are some other experimental episodes? Oh, we've got an April Fool's episode coming up.
Oh, we definitely have the April Fool's episode. I don't know if we're going to do anything for St. Paddy's Day. Last minute episodes, like the Valentine's Day thing came up very
really
last minute. We should have done it sooner, but looking ahead, I was like, I don't know what I want to do for Valentine's Day. And same thing with St. Paddy's. I don't know what I want to do for that or Easter. But then when it's there, I'm like, oh, I'm feeling the spirit suddenly. Let's do this episode.
Yeah.
Oh, we have the missing episode. That was an experimental episode.
Yes.
Who listened,
eagle-eared listeners, that doesn't feel right, but I'm gonna keep using it anyway. You will have noticed that we talked about a midweek episode a few weeks back. That never came to be. And that is because we have on deck a episode detailing a bunch of shifter stuff, and it ties in with one of the books.
So I think that when these type of episodes that we put in and we allude to them and they're not there. I think this may happen in the, again a few times in the future. It's just because of scheduling, is that we want someone to do a specific thing, but we also don't want to force them into a schedule and allow them to have the time. And because everything is now suddenly time sensitive, we want to leave open the opportunity for those episodes that would make sense in the timeline. That way we can always go back to them if we want to.
A lot of things in Eperon happen on specific dates, especially when you start looking at the novels, when you start looking at
modules,
stuff like that. And we want to make sure that those things happen at least around the date in the podcast that they would have. Sometimes we will change the year because, you know, we have to.
But like the Zorchilic episode, it has to come out in like 3 weeks' time, because in the timeline, that is when it would come out. Him being here makes the most sense during that time, and we're just trying to hammer on those dates and hit certain things. But because, again, scheduling with everything the way it is right now, we understand completely not being able to do things a certain way, and we want to leave those open.
Mm-hmm.
We don't want to not give you an episode because, you know, it couldn't be fit in. We want to give you that. We want to give you everything.
I'm going to do my best to start putting OOC episodes out on Wednesdays if I have any in our backup.
I think we're going to do that, and then also we'll hit Tiny Taverns on Wednesdays when we have that as well.
Yeah.
Just moving, I think after the Valentine's Day episode, we should be able to just go one after the next, after the next, after the next, moving forward. Well, the OOC, again, they're not really bad.
They're not that difficult to edit.
It's just, we have a couple, but I don't know where to put them. It always feels weird just putting out a midweek episode.
It can feel really weird with episodes coming out on Wednesday. I'm okay with it, because sometimes our episodes are late anyway. And I feel like that gives people, like, a little midweek, like, ooh, what is this?
I are you listening to the Out of Character? Do you enjoy them? Because if you guys are actually enjoying them, please let us know, man.
Yeah, tell us what you think about the interviews we do. Because we like doing them, because we like talking to people.
I have several people lined up for Out of Character interviews who don't want to do in-character interviews and just want to come on and talk about their stuff. Because I've reached out to a few people for Tiny Taverns where I was like, hey, here's the plan. And they were like, can we just do the out-of-character portion? And I want to do that, but only if you guys are enjoying. I would do it for that person and help them pitch their stuff. I definitely want to do that. But again, only if you guys are enjoying it.
So we do have a Tiny Tavern coming up, though.
We do. We do have a Tiny Tavern, and I'm really excited about the Tiny Tavern. Because I listened to music from this guest, and I was really excited about it. Like, I really enjoyed the music from them and the way that they had set everything up, and I was like, holy heck, I really want this person on. And it's good. It's so good. And then getting to talk with them on Tiny Taverns and getting to talk to them about music and pretend like I have some idea of what we're doing, it's just nice. I'm so glad to be back at Tiny Taverns. But speaking of which, that is a question that we have had that we weren't sure how to proceed forward, because we're trying to find musicians within D&D and musicians within our genre, and finding people in Eberron's been hard, and then finding people in D&D's been harder. No, Eberron's harder, D&D's hard. But if we were to bring on a guest from outside that, how do you guys feel about that? I don't know how I feel about that. Like, I have a couple of people who are in the D&D sphere that I wanted to reach out to.
Let's say, for sake of argument, for the, like, 10 people who are listening to this Out of Character episode, and who are actually going to write comments. Let's say that for some reason we were able to secure, like, Lil Nas X.
Oh my god, if we got Lil Nas X on, I wouldn't care about anyone else. I would just interview him. No.
Look, man,
I don't care about the tavern at that point in time. I fucking made it. If I get to interview Lil Nas X, I'm done. I quit.
He's so adorable.
That's the peak. That is the... Oh my god.
So let's say we get a big... Somebody who has nothing to do with D&D, but we bring them on to the Tiny Taverns.
Do we have them play a character?
No, we have them be themselves. See, and just a Luffy and Kevin just be an asshole.
I think that would be funny, but then at the same time, how are we going to get those people to come on for that? If they agree to that, they're fucking the best. Absolutely. Like, we're not boosting their numbers at all at that point in time.
No.
It's just a charity case.
Yeah, exactly. They're like, aww, we feel so bad for you, little charity babies.
And also, then, like, if we brought on people to just do out-of-character interviews, is that okay? Do you guys like that? Or should we bring in... Because there's people I want to talk to in the D&D sphere who, again, may not want to come on for specific characters. Is that cool? Is that something that you... I want to know. I want to know what you people want. And then should we interview them as Kevin? Or not Kevin, as Silas and Aloofy? Because Silas and Aloofy interviewing,
we're
like...
We're just piling so many things onto these people because we can't bother to do our own market research.
Like, what kind of market research are we going to do? We have to ask them what they want ahead of time. Like, how are we going to know, hey, these ridiculous ideas we have, will these work? What do you guys think? Who are we supposed to ask? Is there, like, some little computer thing you type in and be like, what if we had on Lil Nas X? How's that going to...
Yeah, you have to rent this computer from the government. And you can ask it questions 3.
I watched a thing recently about how you can boost your YouTube numbers if you ask questions and, like, do little polls on YouTube. And I was like, oh, man, that's a great idea. And then I thought about it, and I was like, I don't have any questions that we want to ask that are... Because it's like, you got to keep them simple. You got to keep them simple yes or no questions. And I'm like, every question I want to ask of you guys is immediately just something like, what about the cosmos?
I want to do more on the YouTube, but I want it to be, like, visual. But we don't have any art that I can make move around. And we don't have any, like, stuff like that that I can...
Maybe we'll just do, like stick art and just have stick art... Just go back heavy 90s, just like, stick characters and have a lot of fun with it. Speaking of things that we want to do for the YouTube specifically, one of the ones that we have been talking about is something where we take different games and play them in the Eberron setting.
Hi, my name's Rebecca, and I love a game called Good Society. Good Society is an RPG it's a Jane Austen RPG where you play... members of the Regency gentry, and you do things like lust at each other from afar and have miscommunication and try and increase your wealth.
Yeah, it's an absolutely wonderful time, but let me just go ahead. Rebecca, didn't you just recently play with the game's creators? Is that a thing that you did?
I mean, one of them, their name's Haley. They're really nice.
Was it fun?
Yeah, it really was. I realized that I was playing the game just a little bit wrong, which is why I wanted to do it before I started writing my hack.
That makes sense. So we're going to do a hack featuring the Tane Gala and the High Society of Sharn.
Yeah, it's called Sharn Society. That's the name of the hack.
I still want it to be called Good Sharn Society. It's just awful.
No,
it feels
I don't
horrible
like that.
In the mouth. No.
No, because, well, the naming convention for Good Society hacks is Blank Society.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah,
that makes sense.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
I've learned yeah. something today. And then we've talked about playing other games in that setting. And I think that one of the things we'd like to do is maybe play with people who aren't the same 5 people we play with every time. Because I think that would be interesting to
maybe.
Play with different people.
No. That's
like,
gross.
I love our groups. I really
You're
do.
Disgusting.
I love all of our groups.
Why would you do this?
Because
I
think
people.
That it would be nice to... Oh, my God. Because Keith Baker's doing it. I'm stealing ideas from Keith. That's our entire business model, is stealing ideas from Keith. That's what we've been doing this whole time.
I mean... I don't think that's quite true.
Is that not true? Is that not, that's not what we're doing here?
No.
I feel like then one of us is got not gotten that memo because I've just been taking all his ideas. Okay, but speaking of Keith, like he liked one of our tweets the other day, and we immediately were like, "Oh God, no!"
So yeah, it's
that's always a thing because we'll all be doing different things in the house, and we're all in different rooms, and then suddenly everyone will stop. And someone will panic scream.
The entire house goes, like, blood-curdlingly silent as one person waits for the other two to see it. And it's really funny because we've literally had conversations with Keith on Twitter, and he's just like a chill guy. And it's just like most people are like, who the fuck is this? But, you know, we die anytime that he likes a tweet or retweets one of our tweets or comments.
There are a couple other people like that, too, who we consider so big in our, like, community and, like, leaders of our community. And if they like our stuff, I'm like, oh, my God. You know?
Yeah.
It's just exciting. It's just, I know. It's, I think it's because we're, like, silly.
Social media noobs.
That might be it. I think that regardless, we will always have that, like, level of, like, oh, my God, every time something happens.
It's true.
I'm still surprised we got Runesmith and Davichev. Because half the time, I don't feel like we deserve, like, to interview these people.
Hashtag imposter syndrome.
It's just...
You got that imposter syndrome.
We reach out to people, and they're like, oh, my God, this is a fun idea. And then they come on, and we're like, ah.
Hello, I don't know what I'm doing, so I'm just going to say words and things. Maybe you'll laugh and have fun with me while I say words and things, please.
I think one of the things that we forgot to mention and I wanted to touch on regarding out-of-character episodes is we're going to do maybe a couple from people who were on initially. We had a few people who helped us right at the start of everything. Benedetto, Amanda.
Eric. Oh, yeah Eric. Yeah.
Eric, yeah. And we're going to bring them on and record with them and do out of character stuff because we wanted to talk with them, but we didn't think that people would care. I mean, I'm being honest. Generally, if you're not, you know,
or they're not bigger names.
They're not bigger names. They're our level.
They're literally like our friends from our hometown that we play D&D with.
And while I absolutely love talking to them and love going over details of stuff with them, sometimes that can be, like, not as fun for you guys. So hopefully you enjoy them. If not, then that's cool, too.
So in the first Out of Character episode we did, I asked if people shipped a Luffy and Silas. And a lot of people have said that no, that's a bad ship. We've had a Luffy and our first guest, Wooderaj.
Wooderaj, yep.
We've had a Luffy and Kevin.
That's awful.
We've had a Luffy and, quote, the jockeys.
The jockeys.
But nobody's been shipping Silas with people.
Which is weird because of all of them, Silas is the most approachable.
Well, everyone, I'm going to close this out with one final call to action.
This is it, guys. It's a call to action.
Who would win in a fight? Kevin Capone or a flock of ducks? My money's on the ducks.
My money's on the ducks, too.
Thank you, everybody, for joining us for this rambling us talking about the plans that we have in the future because we felt bad for not having an episode this week and we wanted to make sure that you guys at least kind of heard our voices.
Yeah, again, this is purely us being selfish. We need to be in your brains constantly. I'm living there, and I need to stay there. Rent is too damn high.
I hope everybody has a really good week. We will see you next Friday with our Silas dating game.
Yeah, well, definitely. Please, again, respond to those flyers. Send us messages. Be a part of this. We love you. Bye.